Today, we are here to talk about all things dead presidents. First and foremost, we want to talk about what is the happy ending that we could have had to dead presidents that keeps Anthony off of that prison bus at the end. And we'll also get into questions like, why so many of y'all hate Juanita so much? And was it fair that the crew basically stole Delilah's money after she was dead? And would Anthony have been better off if he just never got with Juanita in the first place and maybe got with Delilah instead? Do you think Cuddy actually cared about Juanita, or was he just using her? Did Anthony ever even tell his family that he had a child on the way while he was in Vietnam? All of these are things we're going to discuss from the top to the bottom, so stay tuned.
What's up? I'm Height.
And I'm Cherie.
And you've discovered Axiom Amnesia.
In case you missed it, we did a deep dive of dead presidents. It's almost 2 hours long. If you missed it, you should go and check that out. It'll be linked in the description, where we take this movie and go step by step by step. But as you guys know, along the way, we were asking you questions, poll questions, and things like that. We're going to get to those in a minute. But first, we want to thank all of the supporters who've helped to make this video possible. If you want your name to appear alongside these contributors, make a one-time donation via Cash App or click the thanks button on this video, or you can head on over to patreon.com/axiomamnesia or become a channel member by clicking the join button to enjoy all of the benefits of becoming a monthly subscriber. So the first thing we want to talk about is, what is the happy ending that could have happened? How do we keep Anthony off of that prison bus at the end of the movie? At the end of the movie, if you guys don't know, just a quick recap. Basically, what happens is Anthony goes off to war. He comes back. He's having trouble finding work and everything. He's getting pressure from his girlfriend on money. And so he and some of his war buddies and friends decide to try to rob an armored truck. And it all goes bad. And two of them wind up dying. And then the other ones are caught and sent to prison, except one who has an OD. At the end, we see Anthony on this prison bus, and he's going to prison for 15 to life. So how do we keep him off the bus?
One easy thing is to not be involved in this robbery.
I think the low-hanging fruit part of the discussion is, people will probably say, don't go to war because then you don't have the problems. You know, just don't participate in the robbery. But what about the other pressures that led to him participating in the robbery, like his chronic, not chronic unemployment, but being unemployed and his money pressures? He's got one baby and another one on the way, and a woman who is not happy with the...
But I don't know if it's that the war, going to war, being a vet, is what caused him to have the problems. Because as we know, Delilah wasn't there. Kirby wasn't in this conflict, right?
Vietnam. He was in Korea.
So it may have contributed somewhat to some problems, but it's not to say that if he hadn't gone, he wouldn't have problems that other people don't have. Like, people in that time, especially Black folks and stuff, had issues because of the history of the United States of America and its political and economic systems.
Yeah. And that doesn't change. So I just think to myself, man, is there a path where he could have just maneuvered and not, you know, come to this end? And in some cases, it can be that there's this pivotal moment where you go, okay, if I just turn left instead of right, I avoid all of this. But I feel like there were so many challenges for Anthony along the way. You know, he was dealing with like PTSD, and he, you know, was having problems when he came back. He had economic issues, and I don't know that it was any one thing. So does, you know, is it just as simple as, hey, don't rob the bank? Because one thing that you did bring up in the deep dive is the fact that it's who you're around. You know, it's that he was with Kirby. Kirby was a getaway driver already. Kirby was running numbers and doing illegal activities and stuff like that too.
Yeah, so, and when he got back with the same folks, right? Even, you know, Skip, who was probably had his problems, right, from the war that you knew about because you was there with them.
Yeah.
You had Joe.
Right.
Who you went back to, whose idea basically it was. He brought this whole thing up that, hey, if we do this, you know, this happens. They go to the post office. That's their last stop, right?
Motherfuckers tell me everything there is no body explosives, man. Mm-hmm.
So they would not even know about this if he hadn't gone back to some of his old friends. But, you know, that's just how it is when you go back, right? Sometimes it's a different getting in a different environment, sort of like what they tried to do with Menace to Society, which is as much about your environment, right? Mm-hmm. Where if he can go to Atlanta, would his life be different? If you get out of the military and go some other place and, you know, not be pulled back into stuff with people who you may not know is on this other stuff and people who you do know, like Kirby.
Right.
Who was already in the illegal life.
So I'm going to ask this question, which sounds completely nuts, but did he have a better chance of survival if he stayed in the military? If he didn't actually get out and go home? And, you know, that's a question that I think to myself. In the comments, let us know, do you think that Anthony might have had a better chance of a better life and survival and getting out of this situation if he had remained in the military? Because, you know, the war would be coming to an end in a bit if he had just stayed in and then kind of, you know, I don't know, eventually got stationed in Germany or something like that. Or, you know, would that have given him a better chance to not be on that prison bus in the end? And it also could have saved the lives of Delilah and Joe as well in the process, because if they never do this, then Delilah and Joe are still, you know, Delilah's still giving her Black Power speeches and Joe is taking care of his many kids and, you know, still working and doing whatever he does in life. Although I think for the ones who, Skip and Joe, who were kind of like addicts, I think that it was possibly going to lead to a bad end anyway, especially for Skip, because, you know, ODing was a very real possibility anytime he was getting high. And the more you do it and the longer you do it, you know, I don't know. But maybe right. Skip could have gotten clean, but I don't know.
And did he start in Vietnam? And if so, would he not have started, gotten addicted back at home?
So what do you think? What if he stayed in the military?
I think he would have been all right.
Yeah.
I think so. Depending on what, I think it was 73 when he got out, and maybe mm-hmm. if he didn't go on another tour, but you never know. But then, so what they do is during these conflicts, they ramp up, right? We need X number of people. And then after that, then they're like certain number of people have to go, right? Then they're cutting down the size of the force. So would you be allowed to stay is another thing, too, which is possibly
but would you
not
be allowed
a possibility.
To stay? But OK, so my question is, if you get drafted and you're in and you have to, you know, the conscription or whatever they call it, you're in, then are you out when they say go back home, or are you like in and you determine when you leave?
No, you're in until the end of your contract, right?
OK.
But then you... What I'm saying is, if he wanted to stay in, it doesn't mean he can necessarily stay in, even if because the volunteer force could be bigger than the force that they want after the war. Right.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
So, yeah. But one thing we did ask on the community tab was, would Anthony have been better off if he never got with Juanita and got with Delilah once they were older after he served in Vietnam?
As you know, Delilah and he, from the very beginning, had this kind of chemistry that was there. Well, Anthony comes to the door and we realize that, you know, there's this supposed to be, you know, younger teenage girl who is at the door saying, hey, I heard your truck, you know.
You're kind of early.
I heard your truck.
There seems to be this dynamic almost of flirting between the two of them.
Seems like you hear my truck every morning.
And we'll later find out that this is Delilah, who is the younger sister of Juanita, who is Anthony's girlfriend.
Try working on your first boyfriend.
I'm too busy studying to be writing about boys.
I do think, looking back on it, that they probably would have been a better fit. Now, in the beginning, Delilah was like a few years younger. Now, who knows how much younger she really was? You know, I would estimate maybe she was 3, maybe 4 years younger than they were, you know, which I don't think is an unreasonable age gap or anything. Maybe before he left for war, it wasn't, you know, it wouldn't have been, because, you know, they had her in ponytails and stuff, even in that part of the movie when it was before the war. So, you know, he would have had to wait. So he could have gone off to war. Then when they meet back up again, if he never got with Juanita, then it could have just been as simple as he wound up going to the meeting. He runs into her. They smile. And then they're free to pursue whatever could be between them. But does he still come up with this, you know, telling her about, hey, I got this plan for some money? Or is it that because he doesn't have a family, maybe he's living at home with his parents and yes, he needs money, but the need to take care of a child and one on the way is, you know, is not as great, right? He's got a little bit more time.
And then maybe like the people you're around. So if you do have these pressures at home and then you have those same outside influences, maybe you're not as swayed. You're like, because maybe I came back and I'm talking to my woman about, you know, the plight of Black folks in America now, you know, and from the and thinking of it from the perspective of a vet, then now I'm on to different things, right? So y'all over here talking about what you gonna do, you know, about this armored truck and what it does, mm-hmm. but I'm not really thinking about going and robbing the actual truck.
Yeah. And so in that poll, though, a lot of you voted and 87% of you said, yes, Anthony would have been better off if he never got with Juanita, meaning they never had anything going on in high school or right after. They never had the kid. He never gets her pregnant. They never do anything. And then he gets with Delilah instead, once they were old enough after he served in Vietnam. Yeah.
But a question I would have is, would they get together? Because like the way he came back totally with political views that's opposite of Juanita. I don't know if that would have lasted as long. Maybe he could have been swayed by the movement.
And it may not have been a forever thing, right? All he needed was it to be enough. And they might have needed, because, I mean, you know, she was in college and, you know, in college, you might date a person. That doesn't mean that that's who you're going to be with forever, ever. And so maybe it could have been enough to show him different things, to show him,
I don't know.
You know, to
but
sway
I'm saying
him.
Like maybe after one or two conversations, they're not getting together.
I don't know. I think that her adoration for him early on might have gone a long way. So in spite of the fact that he had these different political views at the time, you know, the fact that she always had a crush on him, you know, would have given him some grace in that situation. Maybe. Now, would it have lasted? Not unless he gave up his government brainwashing. Huh. Right. It couldn't have lasted without that. Most of you thought, hey, Delilah was the better pick. And I happen to agree with that. Do you?
Yeah.
It just might not have lasted. Back to this question of, what are the things that can keep Anthony off the prison bus in the end? What about the idea Anthony marries Juanita before the war? Because we did see that Marisol and Jose Joe got married before, and Juanita was trying to pressure Anthony to marry her. You know, she's like, hey, you know, they're getting married. I want to give it, you know, kind of thing. We should get married.
You know, Marisol and Jose going down to City Hall tomorrow. To get married? What you think about that?
And Anthony says nothing and she rolls her eyes.
Nothing, I guess.
Now, this is going to become very important because, as we know, he's going to the Marine Corps and he's going to end up in Vietnam, right? And how will he and how will she just wait for him, basically, right? She's going to have to go out and work or find somebody to work, you know. And he's going to be off, right? But the difference with Marisol and Jose is they're going to have a family. He's going to get paid more because he has dependents, at least one dependent, his wife, right? So she won't have to worry about working while he's off in war. But on the flip side, when you have someone, a relationship like Anthony and Juanita, then he's going to be off in Vietnam, not married and not making the extra money to send back even to his girl, right? So she's just going to have to be in a way,
figuring
it out on her own back in the States.
But see, if he had married Juanita, then Juanita would have had money coming in. And you brought this up in the deep dive that we did into the movie. Juanita, you know, the child would have been more cared for. Juanita would have had money coming in. Anthony would have gotten paid more money from the government. And Juanita wouldn't have felt like she was out there alone. So even if he wasn't like writing back all the time, she would have known, I'm married, I'm being held down, he's going to be back hopefully if he doesn't die over there, and not have been in the position to need Cuddy's help.
Yeah, so basically what you're saying is because of these factors is why we know about this character, Cuddy. That's the whole reason that Cuddy is in the film, right?
Yeah, because she started dating Cuddy at some point, right? And so I think it resolves that situation if they got married. And a lot of y'all, oh, he barely knew her. He shouldn't have married. But, you know, think of the time. A lot of people got married. They made it last. They made it work. And maybe they didn't, you know. But the point is, he did what was, he might have done what was right for the moment. Now, in the moment when he left, he didn't know she was pregnant, you know. So that's to be considered, too. It's different if you know, hey, I have a child and this is the reason. But if he had somehow felt like he could marry, but neither did Marisol wasn't pregnant either, as far as I know. So they got, Jose and his wife got married and they didn't have children yet either. So I think it would have been reasonable. And then Juanita could have felt like, okay, I have this connection with him. I've made my promise that I'm going to be here for him. And, you know, it could have worked out that way. But so that's what I think. And then when he came back, they still would have been a family or whatever. But the best case scenario would have been if they could have relocated someplace else where he wasn't just relying on, you know, all of the crew that he knew from the neighborhood. If he wasn't relying on Kirby and all of them, where maybe if he could have stayed in, it might have been nice if he was stationed in, I don't know, California or someplace else, just any place else, yeah. You know, so that he could have an opportunity to not have those same influences on his life. I think that could have kept him off the prison bus.
Yeah. But we asked a question.
We asked a lot of questions, y'all.
Okay. One of them, let's start with Cuddy and Juanita's relationship.
Uh-huh.
We asked, do you think Cuddy really cared about Juanita or was he just using her?
80% of you said he was using her. 20% of you said that he actually cared about her. First of all, I was perplexed because a few of you had the gall to question and say, using her for what? Because he had money. Well, what things might a man like Cuddy use Juanita for? Companionship, being around her. You know, there's more than just money out here. But anyway, so what do you think? I mean, do you think he cared about her or do you think he was using her?
I think he cared, like, because let's say you're a pimp, mm-hmm. like he's coming around all the time for what? Like if he's not putting it on a stroll.
But
not
was he
yet.
A pimp? Was he a pimp? We know that he was a drug dealer.
In
but
the
was
70s,
he a
if
pimp?
You, I don't know, if you dress like that, you probably are. I don't know.
Oh my god.
That
gosh.
Just seems like the pimp's uniform.
I
don't know.
I'm not ready to say he was a pimp. And in
but
fact,
all right, so in the film, to me, the way you showed everybody else dressed and the way you showed this guy dressed, I'm to conclude that he was a pimp. And maybe he wasn't. But
go to the comments. Was Cuddy a pimp or was he not? I'm saying he could have been a pimp, but we don't know that for sure. And I just don't want to put that on Cuddy's head. Cuddy had enough going on. We know that he is probably a dealer, right? We know that because of what Cowboy said.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, we do know that. But okay, it doesn't matter. I say he didn't do that to her, right?
Mm-hmm.
He didn't put her out there. And he's coming around. So if you're coming around like that, like what else is and asking about the baby and giving the money, you don't need to do this. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I think he did care, but at the same time, you can be doing this because you know, you just want something from her. You know, y'all know what I'm talking about, right?
Yeah,
and,
I mean, you just
and
made
if I'm making $600,000 a day, a week, a month, then handing her, you know, $500-$600 in those times, well, $100-$200 is mm-hmm. like nothing, right?
Right, right. Which we calculated was like what, about $1,300 or something in today's money.
Yeah,
you know, it is nothing. He got it to give, and so on. And another thing I think we should talk about is the dynamic of men with money and women who don't have it and they know that they need it. The dynamic is set up where there is this power thing where the person with the money gets to call the shots. So he's coming around and he can make her as happy or unhappy because of what money he gives or doesn't give. But like, let's not get it twisted. Whatever money that was still wasn't enough yeah. money to keep her out of this roach infested apartment.
Again, because Anthony wasn't doing it. Anthony wasn't doing it. He was at war. He knew he had a kid
mm-hmm.
and he wasn't sending money home for his daughter. That's what, because he didn't even, he said, you know, he don't write. He don't think about none of that. You know, so whatever's happening over there, Cuddy is taking care of his kid.
Right. Samuel Taylor, he made the comment that he cared. If he was just using her, he would have fell all the way back once he seen her with Anthony, or he wouldn't have looked out for her when Anthony lost his job or tried to help out Anthony too. He was a snake, but he did care.
I don't know about
I think that I, you know, well, let me just backtrack. I do think he was a snake, but I think he cared as well. Yeah. Like,
but let's say you don't need to care about somebody to creep. Like, let's say you don't need to care about somebody to creep with a married woman, right? Or do you?
Probably so, not. I would say if you're creeping with her, you don't care necessarily.
Well, I'm saying you can or you can't, right? It could be either or. But, you know, that's just how it is, you know? But it make a point, like, but for him to continue to come around and confront Anthony,
says a lot. He wanted to run Anthony off in a way. But I think this is also still part of the power that we can't read too much into, because, you know, I think he wanted to be the man of power in her life. And if Anthony is there and he's providing and doing all these things, he can't be that, right? Because again, a lot of this is about power. You know, he might have had a few little women here and there all around town, right? But he's taking care of all of them. But that is the power dynamic, is to be able to control this woman and her, what she's doing. And with Anthony there, he can't control like he might have been able to control in the past with his money. And he ain't got to care about Juanita to just want to control her. But I do think that he showed that he invested time in the child. He, you know, cared about what happened to the child to some degree. I would think if he really, really cared, because I don't think Cuddy was probably living in no roach infested apartment like that. He wasn't trying to take her out of the condition. He was just trying to, you know, make it a little more comfortable in the condition that she was in. And I don't know, that kind of, that speaks something to
me. So maybe that indicates whether or not he actually cares.
Maybe, yeah. Now we're getting around to the fact, maybe he really didn't, or he didn't care that much, right?
Yeah. Maybe it's like, so you come from a certain background, right? And this is acceptable for the people here, right? And even if I exalted myself to a higher level, I still say this is acceptable to, you know, the people from where I am from, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you deserve this. It's not that much out of the ordinary for you to be in a place like this, right?
Yes.
So I don't need to do anything extra.
Yes,
but,
I agree.
You know, back to Anthony and Cuddy, we had another question that we asked about this, because
yes,
Anthony wasn't caring for his family back home, right?
Mm-hmm.
We said in Dead Presidents, Cuddy tells Anthony that he deserves some respect for taking care of his woman and child while he was away in the Vietnam War. Do you agree or disagree with Cuddy?
I just dropped by to see Juanita and Sarah, you know.
About to see my baby.
I took care of your woman and your baby when you went to war. Yeah, a man ought to get a little respect for something like that.
75% of you all said that you disagree.
He don't deserve no credit.
No credit. And 25% of you said that you agree that Cuddy deserved some respect. I do think that Cuddy deserved respect for what he did for her, because it doesn't change that he did something. But I don't know, his respect points, if you look at him as a whole bucket, you know, but the other stuff he did knocked him down and made him not deserve respect, right?
So people like to bring in all sorts of things in the equation that doesn't go into the equation, right?
Right.
So if you just take everything away that, oh, he's with this dude's girl and coming around and stuff, this is a guy who was presumably taking care of a kid. Well, Juanita said it, taking care of a woman and her kid while her husband is off in war, acting like they don't exist.
Mm-hmm.
That's what Cuddy did.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Just a woman with a kid, sending her, giving her money and stuff to, so
make
that
ends
she's not
meet every month.
Yeah. While her husband is just nowhere. Right. So basically you're just a single mother.
Yeah.
So there's some respect, like, but I don't know if you take into account why he did it, but we still don't know exactly why. So I default to the positive. Most people default to the negative, even though they would call me pessimist because I always think about the negative, right? But I'm going, when it's benefit of the doubt, I always tend to point towards the positive side. And yeah,
I mean,
there's some respect that he deserves.
Respect for that, but at the same time, Cudi should have backed off. Cudi shouldn't have been. But
that was
but,
after the fact, though,
but,
right?
Yeah, but for what he did while he was away, I mean, he dated her for some period, and even after they weren't dating anymore. And we're going to get to this discussion because a lot of y'all feel like, you know, they were still getting it on and everything. I'm not willing to say that, but I would say he deserves credit because he didn't have to do it. He continued to look out for them and he didn't have to do it. But where Cudi was wrong was not backing off when he saw that Anthony was back in the picture, and antagonizing Anthony like that and wanting to basically have Anthony bow down, emasculating him. He was disrespectful to Anthony from the get-go. You know how he was when Juanita tried to introduce him and he just ignored Anthony like he didn't exist. So he got points knocked off, but
why?
Yes, he deserves.
So, okay, let's say.
Because it was disrespectful.
Okay. I'm a man.
Yes.
I know this woman who has a kid who is struggling and this guy is making money and totally ignoring his family. And then he just show up like, I'm daddy and I'm home.
Mm-hmm.
Does he deserve respect for it? You know, what respect does Anthony deserve for what he done and just came back like big happy family now?
Some of you all
right
would say
when
Anthony
he was a dead
fighting for his
Anthony
life
was
in
a
war.
Deadbeat.
Ooh,
that's what he was. People like, oh, somebody was in the comments like he was trying to stay alive and there was no time to write. He was writing Kirby. You're not
Kirby.
Just at war dodging bullets the entire time. They go back to the rear and to the forward operating bases and just chill. And if you're like infantry, you're probably doing that a lot, right? Just sitting around doing nothing, which gives you time to write. So, and I know.
I mean,
most of the time.
We got to talk about shots fired. Shots fired.
We talked about, I was telling you, about movies about the military.
Yeah.
And a very good portrayal that everybody liked was Jarhead. Because it just showed, like, you're not going to do all this stuff now, right? These types of wars that was after Vietnam. But in Vietnam, there was a lot of time where it was just idle. Because that's just, you go on a mission, you come back, right? And in between, you're still not doing anything. You seen they was in bivouac and doing all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
They wanted, like, you, I'm a warrior. I want to kill, right? Mm-hmm. You don't get to do that. You don't get to go out and do much, right? You're a lot of idle time. And that's what the movie actually showed, which is very different from all the other movies that just show a whole bunch of action. Like, this is all that's going on.
Yeah, I mean, and now to be fair, these are different conflicts. I know it might be different if you're looking at a World War II, war movie, Korea versus Vietnam versus, you know, the wars of the
where you're just in the bush the entire time. But we seen in this movie they were not.
Yeah, because he was back at base sometime. They had time to be with the women. And
yeah, so that's what happened. He wrote Kirby.
Yeah.
But he didn't write his family. He didn't send money back. And none of that. And Juanita said, I needed money. And we didn't know what happened to you, whether you were alive or not. One thing that people might bring up is that Anthony, the character himself, said, I can't be in that world, Skip, because the minute I do, I'm a dead man. But I don't think that's true. One thing to not have to worry about is whether or not your child is eating at home. And that's one less thing to worry about that could keep your mind at ease while you're here at war doing this crazy stuff.
And I'm sympathetic to Anthony and the mental stuff that he must have been going through. But he did drop the ball on the family. Now, when he returned, he tried to do the right thing. But even when he returned, he still didn't go directly over there and be like, you know, let me take care of my child and let me, you know, do what I need to do. And the thing is, Anthony, some of y'all are going to say these ain't his kids and stuff, and we'll have to get to that in a minute, too. But the question is, for the comments, was Anthony a deadbeat temporarily during the time while he was in Vietnam up until when he showed back up to Juanita? Was he being a deadbeat? And objectively, he might have had an excuse, but objectively, he wasn't paying for them, and he could have been. He could have been.
Yeah.
Because if he put them on the, you know, his paperwork or whatever, he could have been paying for his child.
Right.
And he wasn't.
Think about it. So if you're out there, you really don't need money, right? You can send most of everything you get back for your daughter or your family and your wife. If I don't know if he viewed her as his wife or whatever.
He didn't.
But,
clearly.
You know, but you, he don't need that much. So to, there's no way that people can say he probably didn't have enough money. He could be sending stuff back.
Yeah, because he didn't have to care for his own needs at that point.
Yeah, maybe you just need some toiletry type stuff every once in a while, but probably not, right?
Yeah. And what did he do with his money when he came back? He went and got him some clothes so he could walk in.
Ooh, that boy was fly.
He was sharp walking in there, you know, with his hat tilted to the side. He was leaning when he walked into Kirby's after he came back from the war. So, you know, again, these are questions that are not exactly explicitly stated in the movie, but things that we have to ask. Yes, Anthony is a sympathetic character, but was he temporarily a deadbeat? Let us know in the comments.
So, you know, you brought this up. One thing that we asked in the community tab is, in Dead Presidents, when Anthony returns home from Vietnam, he avoids seeing Juanita and his daughter until he has secured a job. Was this the right thing to do? Consider that he purposely chose not to contact them while he was away at war. So this dude, I mean, I can't be in the world, Skip.
You know how I survived 26 months in the bush? Because I don't think about the world, Skip. That shit don't exist to me.
He get back in the world and Skip, you know, the first thing, one of the first things Skip says, who try to act like a player or whatever, talking about I'm a pimp, you know, he's like, man, you need to go over there and see your daughter.
I saw Juanita the other day, man. Finer than a motherfucker. You need to go check her out, man. Go see your little daughter.
So here we have Skip, who is, you know, is high probably most of the time. He's like still like encouraging him to go see his family.
And he did not. He's looking for a job, going to Kirby. He, like you said, he bought the clothes. He was walking in Kirby's looking all cool and stuff. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Flexing, and still hadn't gone see his daughter and his woman.
Yeah. And he doesn't show. And he doesn't show up until he has a job. Now, again, I'm like, I get that she has needs and he doesn't want to come empty handed. But I don't think he would have been empty handed at that moment, because he would have had some money from when he first got out, right?
Yeah, he had the money he saved up from not spending while being out in war, right?
Yeah, let's talk about that for a minute. If you've been in war and you come back home and you haven't been spending there, then you got you got some money.
Let me tell you, I was in the Marine Corps. People used it like a savings plan. A lot of people wanted to go to Iraq, Afghanistan, because you get paid a little more, right? Your hazard zone, all that other stuff, right? Mm-hmm. And you don't spend as much. So when you come back, you're coming back with like a savings, right, that you didn't have before. And if you are married, right, if you had a dependent like a kid, another dependent like a kid, because your wife is looked at like a dependent, right, like a kid, then you're getting even more, right? All of this stuff adds up, right? But he didn't do his paperwork. He still would have gotten single pay.
Mm-hmm.
And been basically saving up. So when he gets home, he has money. I don't know if the filmmakers consider this, but he has to, unless he just spent it all. I know people who spent a whole bunch of money.
But he didn't look like he was just blow everything. You know, he didn't seem like, I mean.
And where's you spending it? Because most of the time it just seemed like they was on tours.
I mean, what could you have spent your money on? Like, so I think it's safe to say he would have had some money.
Yeah. So he did not need to wait till he found a job. I guess it's, to some people, it's like, yeah, you need to show that you are whatever, but you've already shown that. It's like, hey, I went to the Marine Corps, I worked, and me showing up with the money is the fruit of my labor. So I don't need a job to show you that I'm taking the proper steps or I'm responsible. I'm responsible in the fact that I earned money and I still have some now, even though I'm looking for my next gig.
Mm-hmm.
But 61% of people said that no, it was not the right thing.
It was not the right thing. Thank goodness you guys are on the right side of history and logic and morals with this one. It wasn't the right thing to do. You guys mostly saw that, you know, look, you should have been making a beeline to your family, at least your kid, you know, and whatnot when you got back. And so,
yeah. I would think that's the first thing you do if you're not a deadbeat. The first thing you do is, I'm home. Let me go see my daughter. He went see his parents and stuff. I could kind of understand your parents if you're like young. He went off at 18, probably didn't grow up while he was out there. And then I got to see my mama. You know what I'm saying? When you have a whole daughter.
But Peace-Minded 5512 brings up a good point. She says he needs to be able to show he has done everything he can to support them and be somebody, someone they can respect. The distance he imposed from the war made it where he had to show up with some respectability.
No,
you can't choose to be absent and then pop back up with no means to help.
It's to what we said, though. So the way to show it, because one of her statements was, ain't no free meals here, right? So what she's looking at it as, you get nothing out of the military when this is what should have provided for your family. You show up with the money from the military to show instead of, I'm going to act like none of that exists, right? And then it causes her to not respect what you went through and what you've done, like that actual volunteering to go and serve and to be paid. So now you have to show up with a job.
Right.
But if you would have showed up with money from the military, she may have looked at it different. Like, okay, so now he could take care of his child off of this time away.
And then, that would have been respect, right? And I think we're saying similar things because a lot of people aren't considering that you have this lump sum of money.
Yeah,
to come back,
exactly.
Right? You know, so, but I agree with her. Like, it's his decision, his choice to be distant and not be communicating while he was in Vietnam.
That
caused
him
to have to kind of, like, I got to do it big when I show up because I ain't been around, right? Whereas if he had been writing, he could have showed up broke.
Yeah.
You know.
And then because you write and you communicate those problems, right? Oh, it's tough. We had a tough day. You know what I'm saying? And then it makes it easier probably on you once you get back. Where, hey, we had a tough day. I stayed up 20 hours. You know what I'm saying? Just like, you don't have to explain everything. But then when you get back, the people you come across kind of know that, you know, you've been some of your issues and stuff, right? And then they'll probably be more respectful in that sense and not talking about your silly ass dreams.
Another commenter, Asia, said, I'm not going to say that he was right or wrong. All I can say is I understand. He always struck me as wanting so badly just to be a good dude. And see, I think this is where wanting to be a good person, trying to be a good person and having that, putting that into action, through intentional, you know, actions is very different.
I think that's most people, right? I think most people want to be good people. But whether their actions or their beliefs fall in line with that is something else.
Yeah.
Right? I think most people just genuinely want to be good people. Other people probably just don't. They don't care, right? But most of the time when you come across somebody, they want to be good people and they think they are being good.
Yeah, well, everybody thinks they're a good person, which is interesting because, you know, we see people constantly complain about all the bad people they know and the people who don't do the right things, but yet everybody thinks they're good. So, like, who are these bad people?
Man, it reminds me of a Bone song. It may have been, I don't know, when Two of the Bones got together from Bone Thugs and Harmony, and it's this song, Am I a Good Person? It's a really good song. Maybe we throw a clip in.
Yes. Or is it something I'm telling myself to sleep at night? Young Fire 9361 says, I understand not contacting anyone while at war, but when he came home, he should have. Around that age for young men, most of us are trying to figure out how to be a man, and a lot of times pride and insecurities get in the way. All right. The other thing I want to talk about is examples that Anthony had. Anthony was living in a two-parent home with a father who was clearly present in there, taking care of his family, doing what needed to be done, who was also a war vet, as well as Kirby, you know, seemingly responsible for, you know, running this business and other things like that. So it wasn't like Anthony was like, I had, well, yeah, maybe Kirby wasn't taking care of his kids. I don't know. But
you had Jose. He was taking
care
of his kids.
You had Jose taking care of his kids. So everybody around Anthony, nobody was a deadbeat around Anthony. And I think that maybe Anthony just took it for granted, right? You know, somehow when you have these things, like, you know, you got a good supportive kind of supportive family and everything, you're not looking at it like this is, you know, I just know that I want to be my own person. But part of what his father was probably in trying to instill in him was being a good, responsible man. And he did drop the ball on that for a time.
Anthony ain't want that kid, and he was in denial.
Mm.
So when he told Skip, Skip was like, groovy, man, groovy, right?
Yeah, groovy.
He was more happy for Anthony than Anthony when he said he had a daughter.
He was like, I just can't look at her face, man. I can't. So you think Anthony was making excuses?
Yeah.
He just didn't want the kid.
Yes, and the way that is, and the way that movies work, it allows for the viewers to make those same excuses, right? Because otherwise, the movie doesn't work. By the time you get to the end, you need to have the sympathy and all of that.
Right.
Right. So you have, there has to be reasonable mm-hmm. excuses, you know, that you could kind of be like, well, maybe, maybe not. Right. But yeah, the viewer gets to make those same excuses and excuse Anthony.
Yeah. Yeah. And there are folks in the comments who were like, Anthony was not a deadbeat, you know, who specifically say that he wasn't a deadbeat. And then they'll also try to blame Juanita, right? Killer Dog 456 said, imagine if he didn't secure a job before, especially when she got pregnant again and started missing that money she was getting from Cuddy, right? So in other words, you know, Juanita, he had to show up with a job and with money because of Juanita. It's Juanita's fault. It's kind of like we going back to that whole, you know, it was Raheem's baby's mama's fault that he went and you know, and was tried to do the robbery or did the robbery.
Yeah.
You know, you got to blame this woman because she made demands,
because
reasonable demands,
because
on taking care of your children.
He ignored them. He acted like they didn't exist for years. So
years.
She went on with her life.
And
so,
you know,
it's her fault.
She went on with her life. And you know, that brings...
And then basically stopped it, right?
Mm-hmm.
She's like, oh, now this guy's back. Now I'm just make a...
She dropped everything.
A 180 right now. Yeah. Because this
everything.
Dude just popped back up one day. Just out of nowhere.
Yep. Speaking of which... We ask another question, which is a little bit more about Anthony's family since I just talked about his dad. But we asked the question about, do you think Anthony told his parents he had a child while he was in Vietnam? Because when he returned from the war, there was no mention of his daughter, like at the scene where they're having, you know, he goes to his parents' house and they're eating and the mother's asking questions about his experiences. He doesn't even mention it. And I'm like, there is no way that a mother like Jennifer Lewis in this movie is going to have a grandbaby up the street and not be taking care of them, looking out for them. So once again, the fact that he didn't even tell that he had a child, I don't believe he told them. I
so
think they found out probably when he moved
say?
In. 83% of you said, no, he did not tell his family that he had this baby while
Bruh,
he was away in
all
Vietnam.
This stuff is just stacking up against Anthony. He didn't tell him in Vietnam. He didn't acknowledge his kid and the mother.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't tell his parents.
Mm-hmm.
He told Skip. I don't know if he told Kirby, but all this stuff. And then he get back. He don't go and see them. And mm-hmm. like, oh, it's just crazy. I think his mama would have brought it up. And I don't know. You because it's a film, you can say they just didn't show it.
Yeah, but nah. That would have been pivotal. His mama would have been like, you've been over there to see Juanita and that baby? Because you know that's the type of mother that he had. She
yeah.
was going to be in that business.
Before about are you on drugs and all that, it was like, where's my grandbaby?
Yeah.
You know how Jennifer Lewis talks.
Yeah, she'd have been like, where's my grandbaby? You know, so we know this, and you know, I'm sure that you could look around and you know families like this. Anthony had kind of like no excuse from his family side. Like, it wasn't like, oh, I had such hardship, and they had a nice big old house. They were well taken care of. Anthony was solidly middle class. Anthony was struggling in a sense because of his choices, not because he didn't have you know, from his background, his family had some money.
Hmm. Yeah, they was doing.
They would have taken care of that baby if they knew the baby existed. And my guess is that Anthony told them, because he, when he came home, he probably went stayed with them, right?
Yeah.
And so he told them about this baby probably when he got with Juanita and moved on out.
Yeah, right? So
that's when they find out, oh, even, you got a whole 3-4-year-old kid.
Even when he was off at war, your mama and your daddy is probably going to be like, let me go drop some money off to Juanita since our deadbeat son ain't doing it.
They would have done it. And then the other part is they understood that, like, okay, a little bit of credit for Anthony. He was young. Anthony was just barely, you know,
not
Anthony
credit, went that's straight excuse.
From, well, okay, a little bit of an excuse for Anthony. He was young. And a parent knows that, you know, just it's kind of like at the age where you send your kid off to college. You know that kid ain't all the way ready. You know that they still need parenting, right? They still need a mama and a daddy. And that is what you were there for. That is what they were there for when they discouraged him from going into the military, right? They were there to kind of tell him, hey, look, we're not trying to run your life, but we're trying to guide you. And if he had listened, maybe a lot of he wouldn't be on that prison bus at the end.
Yeah, and that's part of it. Like when he shows back up, I think he shows back up as the same 18-year-old who left.
Yeah, yeah.
So everybody else is probably, you know, 21, 22-ish, however, early 20s.
Yeah.
And he shows up as an 18-year-old.
Because his life was on hold while he was fighting this war. So he learned about war. He learned about how to stay alive. He learned about things that wouldn't necessarily translate when he went back to his regular life.
And in a time where there's not such conflict, then he may have matured or grown up. But not in this time in Vietnam. I don't think so. Especially if you're not keeping in contact with the regular world. But yeah, for him not to tell his parents, that's just very strange.
Yeah. Yeah. I think that's very like it's strange. And imagine how it would feel to Juanita because you feel abandoned. You know, you would feel like, okay, I'm out here on my own. I got to figure it out on my own.
And
because
maybe
that's basically what she had to do.
At least one person probably brought it up, but why didn't she go to his parents?
That is a good question. So listen, I'm going to really go out on a limb here because this is something that I observed. But the question is, they might have lived in a similar neighborhood and gone to school together, but were they of the same socioeconomic class, Juanita and Anthony? And I say this because, you know, let's say a mama like Anthony's mama is maybe hovery. She's like, look, I'm going to have two college graduates.
Yeah,
son.
But see, I think that's pointing it out, right? That she may be from the class that Juanita is from. And there's supposed to be this next generation.
Which is why she wouldn't want a Juanita for her son. You understand what I'm saying? Like, she feel like we got this nice house and whatever. She's married.
Yeah, Juanita's but I don't think Juanita knows this, right? She just know that Anthony is like me, right? So I'm going to go to his parents.
But I don't think, I don't know. Does she think Anthony is like her?
I don't know indicator that his family would be different besides that it's two parents.
Well, I'm imagining that in some of the conversations, and this is just imagining, complete speculation, not seen in the movie, but like, you know, when you're talking and getting to know a person, she knew he had a daddy living at the house, so that would have made maybe multiple incomes, or at least more incomes than her mother who had to work all hours.
But are you thinking about this at 17, 18?
Probably, maybe
social
not.
Status, right? Or
maybe
economic
not.
Status.
Maybe you felt embarrassed, you know, because that's another thing. Okay, so let's say forget the socioeconomic part of it. Maybe you felt embarrassed that you got knocked up by this woman's son and that he's basically
off
ghosted
at war,
you.
Yeah.
And,
off at war,
you know,
ignoring
you're
you.
And no telling how the mother treated her, because what we do know is Juanita is not living at home. At the point when Anthony comes back, she's got her own roach infested apartment, which is not the same as the nice house that she was in with her mother.
Maybe
working.
That's the one Cuddy paid for.
Her fingers to the bone. Cuddy paid for the roach infested apartment.
Yeah,
y'all go
so
to the
see,
comments. Let us know. Did
maybe
Cuddy
was
own
even
roach
better than we
apartment?
Than we give him credit for. Maybe Cuddy was like, hey, I could break you off a couple
said,
hundred
you
for
your own
apartment
place so I can roll through. Young blood.
That was Cuddy. Yeah.
Okay, but it was still nasty. She was better off at home.
The sister was still at home.
So?
I'm just saying. She was
you know,
still at
I mean,
home.
So the sister was still living at home. But she was in college. See, so the question is, did Juanita get kicked out? Like, is that maybe
Juanita was in school, too.
After? Juanita had to have a baby and do all of that first.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, Juanita's mother say,
girl, you can stay at this house and I'm gonna help you with my grandbaby. I don't think Juanita's mother, her mother seemed very no nonsense, and I don't know if she would have had her there with that baby. We don't know.
But my point is that, so she was in school, right? I don't know how she's paying for that and working and had his kid in the 70s.
Yeah,
because she's
Superwoman. Because it had to get done. The baby had to eat, and she didn't meanwhile, have the luxury
Anthony
of
is
being
just like,
I
just,
can ignore
you
this
don't
child.
Exist.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And see, this is the part that, you know, definitely gets under my skin with the people who can't stand Juanita, is that they're failing to look at the position she was left in. It took two to tango. They both laid down and made that baby together.
Yeah.
But she was left holding the bag.
Exactly. So when Anthony gets home and he talks to Skip, go see your kid. He goes see his parents, right? And then he finally decides to go to, see his family, his kid and everything. Delilah opens the door when he knocks at Juanita's mama door, I presume.
Mm-hmm.
And Delilah's taking care of the kid. She kisses him on the lips and all this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, he find out she's one of these revolutionary ones. He ends up going to see her because, I don't know if it's because he needed somebody for the robbery. But he showed up and he convinced her to get in on the robbery and everything. And then, basically, they messed the plan up, the military cats. And then Anthony is about to get knocked off by one of the guards or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And Delilah jumps up out the, you know, the iconic scene that they had in all the trailers and stuff.
Yes.
Jumps out of the dumpster, mm-hmm. starts blazing and knocks off the cat who was about to kill Anthony. So she basically risked her life for Anthony, which is, I don't even think we brought this
Not
up
even
in the
just
breakdown.
Risk gave.
But like that, I don't think we talked about it, but that is so significant in the actual meaning of that.
Yeah.
Her, the Black revolutionary, gave up her life for this guy who was basically fighting a war opposed to the views of the Black revolutionaries, mm-hmm. right? On behalf of the government, who was doing things basically to knock off this whole movement and these people, right? And she gave her life for that. But then after this, they're talking about with the money to survivors, hey, make sure Jose, because he got knocked off, make sure Jose's piece goes to his children, Marisol, mm-hmm. and all this. And no mention of giving Delilah's cut. She was there.
Mm-hmm.
She participated. Anthony would be gone if she hadn't done what she done. Maybe all of y'all would be gone. Right? Because mm-hmm. you wouldn't have got any money because the guards were basically thwarted the plans.
Right.
She saved everything. So they didn't talk about giving her piece to anybody. And we asked a question on our community tab. Delilah and Joe, Jose, died in a robbery. Is it fair that the crew planned to give Joe's wife his share of the money and kept Delilah's cut for themselves?
This made me so mad.
But we added on, couldn't they have given Delilah's cut to her sister, Juanita?
And you know, and equally as much we could have said to her sister, Juanita, or to her mother. But, you know, Juanita would have, I think, been more in a position to kind of take the money because the mother would have been, where is this money coming from?
Yeah, exactly.
And, you know, so I don't know. But the fact that people ignore that they essentially stole Delilah's cut.
Yeah,
didn't care.
Everybody gets a cut except Delilah, who basically saved the entire. The only reason they have the money
is because of Delilah.
Yeah. And they're just like, most people said it's fair that a person who was involved do not get a share. And that's the arguments that they make. She don't deserve a share because I don't like Juanita.
64% of you said that it was fair that they just divvied up her part and act like she wasn't even there. You know, and it's crazy to me. Now, as I went back and forth in the comments with a couple of people, they were like, oh, well, you know, I didn't really understand that. But most people connected the fact that they hated Juanita, basically, and they didn't want her. Juanita doesn't deserve to get any money. Now, here's the thing, right? Is an inheritance, when, you know, if this was somebody's last will and testament, is that about deserve or is it about who they would leave their money to?
Yeah, Delilah deserves her cut.
Delilah deserved her cut, and her cut deserved to go to who Delilah would have wanted it to. Some of you had some good suggestions, like maybe they could have donated it to her revolutionary cause or anything that she would. I would have been cool with that. But
the question was, is it fair that they gave Jose his share and didn't give Delilah her share?
If you answered that it wasn't fair, or if you believe right now that it wasn't fair, I'm like, okay. But if you think it's fair that they basically stole Delilah's cut, and then you're justifying it for these, because I hate Juanita, Juanita shouldn't have got no money, or whatever.
Or any other reason, like Jose got kids, and so only people who get shares are people who have children.
Yeah,
Kirby,
that's crazy.
They didn't show his kids, so Kirby probably shouldn't get one. But the only, she was the only woman. Mm-hmm. In this thing,
and there was sexism. We know Kirby was outright sexist.
No, I'm just talking about
too.
The commenters, right? We know the commenters know that they were all men and one woman, and it's fair that the woman don't get her cut.
But then some of y'all had the nerve to be like, "Well, Delilah's cut went basically through Anthony, and he would have taken care of his child.
So she get a fraction of something,
Juanita,
of a fraction.
Yeah, basically Delilah, I mean.
It's very different than.
It's crazy.
It's very different than the Terry poll we gave, where all of a sudden light skin with light eyes, you know, deserves the entire world and her whole family is trash. But a group of people who done something together who don't give the dark-skinned lady with a fro their cut is not trash. And it's only fair that she don't get a cut.
And that anything she has should go through this
through
man,
this man.
To decide if her actual blood sister should get to, you know, have basically what she the money that she gave her life for.
Yeah.
You know, it's crazy to me.
And then, like, the portion where you say, yeah, donated to her group, right? Like, that's what she's doing it for, that's the most noble cause to go and, you know, commit this act. And everybody's like, yeah, those revolutionaries don't need none of the money. Let's get all the people who ain't about shit the money.
Well, and how about this, right? Okay, so let's just look at it also from the movie perspective. The movie is saying it, so he's like, make sure Joe get his cut, you know, and give it to, you know, he's all sad and whatever. And he, in the same breath, while he's talking about Joe and his cut, he's still like, damn, Delilah, I hate that you did. You ain't thinking about the money with regard to Delilah, but you're thinking about Joe's wife and his kids and all of that. And it's supposed to make Anthony a sympathetic character. But I would suggest that even the filmmakers didn't even think about Delilah.
Yeah, that's
the
whole
filmmakers
thing.
Didn't even think Delilah was important enough to even mention her in this way. It's sad she's dead, yes. Sad she gave her life for all of us men to live. But she doesn't deserve her cut, and her cut should be filtered through these other men and spent however they deem it should
right.
be spent.
But
like, that's bogus.
A lot of the comments in that basically pointed to Juanita as the reason why Delilah shouldn't get her cut, which just shows that people hate Juanita that much, suggesting that it ain't his baby, so Juanita shouldn't get it, right? Even though the money is for Delilah, it doesn't matter if her sister's kid is for Anthony or whatnot.
Delilah
right?
could have, I mean, and Juanita could have been completely trifling, right? And if Delilah said, "I want my cut to go to her," it should go to her.
Yeah,
that is that. It
that's
it's
the
will
most
to
fundamental.
The person's
but,
next of kin. This isn't about who deserves
yeah,
what.
Yeah, but so Anthony went off to war, ignored his kid, ignored the baby's mother, came back, ignored them for a long time, and then you know, people hate Juanita for. You know, she was still talking to Cuddy, right? And I don't know why they would believe that the babies ain't Anthony's just because he ignored her and she had a boyfriend.
Right.
While he was off at war ignoring them. So now there is hate for Juanita.
Right. And
I agree.
Just had to address that. Yeah.
I agree that, okay, her talking to Cuddy after he was back, after she decided to be with Anthony, is wrong, but it don't warrant the way people look at Juanita after the fact, right?
Yeah.
It was just complete, like, hate for Juanita, to so much so that Delilah shouldn't get her cut because she talked to your boy, Cuddy. after she got back, right? Like, what does that have
and
to
this
do?
Was so obvious when we started asking these questions, when we put out the deep dive breakdown of the movie. All of these things came up. Like, I'm like, I can't believe how people just hate Juanita. And so we did actually make a post dedicated to this. This was not a poll. This was a post. And we said, can we please talk about why a lot of y'all hate Juanita and Dead President so much? There's not a lot of sympathy for Juanita because she kicked the man while he was down. And we get that. So in other words, the way she was talking to him was crazy. She did some things that were disrespectful. But nevertheless, a lot of people ignore what it must have been like to be a young, barely graduated from high school, single mother with no way to make ends meet. And then your man, the man who said he'd be your man when
the
he left.
The big bad Marine.
Is off at war, ignoring you and the child. Didn't even do the minimum, the least he could have done, which is put the kid on the paperwork so some money could be going back home. None of that. Meanwhile, like we said, the man she loved and dedicated herself to, he volunteered to go to war. And he went radio silent on her after she told him that she had his baby. And it wasn't like nobody outside of himself. Skip was like, man, you know, check in with your woman and your kid. You know, other people encouraged him to do that. And he still ignored it because, like you said, maybe he was in denial. Juanita was not talking and acting like the way she acted toward, you know, in the end before she had the baby and had to face the harsh realities of being left on her own to figure it all out while Anthony was away in Vietnam and not responding to her letters. Some of y'all hate her so much that you portray her as a woman of low morals and say that those kids don't even belong to Anthony. And this is what we have to just get to the bottom of right now. What is the evidence in the movie that those kids are not his? Tell me. What's the evidence?
Okay, so what they say is, she said, all right, I'm effing them. And that's their evidence in an argument where she basically say, is that what you want me to say? And then said it
right
during a heated
Anthony,
argument.
Anthony, and to give context, Anthony is pissed off because Cuddy has basically confronted him in the hallway and said that he's been there and given Juanita money. And, you know, Anthony's pissed off about this. And then also they've had this altercation, right?
Yeah.
And so he's already hot about that. And he's like, why is this man coming giving you money? Okay, legit understanding that his gripe is not unfounded. But then when she tells him that they are not continuing a relationship, they are not sleeping together, he would not take that for an answer. And then she says to him, is that what you want to hear? Do you want to hear that I'm doing him? Then he said He said yes. And then she said, all right, then I'm doing it.
Yeah, so right? That's, and even still, even if it's true, that don't mean that this is, that's not his kid. So why do you take this extreme of, now it's not his kid? Why can't you be like,
there's doubt that this is his child and all of that. And I can only conclude that the people who feel like this about Juanita, like, is there some connection in your own world?
Connection of me ignoring my kids.
Are y'all ignoring y'all kids? Is this why y'all kids are being ignored? Is this why? Because, you know, kids who ain't got daddies.
Right, a lot of people say, men, like, she won't let me see the kid, right?
Yeah.
But, and then you try to take your excuse and put it into the character on the movie, right? Even though it's very clear that it was the man's choice not to see the kids. Even though you probably it's probably a choice not to see your kid too when you're talking about, because you can go to court and, you know, but we're not going to talk about all that.
to be able to see him.
But it's just that you were probably young like Anthony, had a kid, and have problems with the baby mama, so you hate baby mamas. And Anthony wasn't doing right, even if y'all have conflict.
And you feel that Anthony deserved respect, the respect of a man who wasn't being a temporary deadbeat.
I know, right?
In spite of the fact of his own actions, he deserved to be treated in such a way, you know, with respect and not talk to in a certain tone, right? Forget all that he put her through.
Yeah, it was like, oh, she did this, she said that. He totally fucking ignored his child for years, came back home and ignored his child. I think all of that is worse than what she's done. Talking about, oh, your silly ass dreams and all that. He ignored his child. That's worse.
Yeah.
You ignored your child.
And she went for the jugular. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
She was talking like wild and crazy and loose, and he couldn't take it. But the point is, what about what she went through?
Yeah.
Who was more wrong?
Part of that
was saying things.
Part of that was he didn't really stand up to Cuddy, right? You had this conflict with Cuddy. He emasculated you. They like to try to say it's women and stuff. This man made you feel like a punk. So you had to go and then basically
beat up on this woman. Beat up on your woman.
Yeah, that's basically what happened in that scene. Even though she said what she said and he had his problems. But part of it was the frustration of what just happened with Cuddy in the hallway.
Because it wouldn't have happened that way. It wouldn't have happened. It wouldn't even be a discussion point.
Yeah.
You know,
but
then you can always go the
back of a turtle.
Wrong. Because Juanita was wrong in some points. Yeah.
Yeah, because old Cuddy wouldn't have been there if she didn't want him there, but he would have still showed up.
But, you know, and I just go back to what is the evidence. And some of y'all even was like, that first kid, there's no proof that first kid. Like, we are still getting comments to today. I just had to stop even answering them because some of them are so ridiculous. You know, that these kids are not his.
Yeah, but we do have evidence that he ignored what who he believed was his kid.
Yeah.
So
he believed it was his kid.
That
first
he was right to ignore who he believed is his kid because it could possibly not be. That could be any child in the entire world.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know. I don't know if this is my kid, so I'm gonna ignore. So all children should be ignored.
did you notice that?
That's one of the dumbest arguments.
The hint was when Skip was like, that baby looked just like you.
Yeah.
So,
that's,
like,
they dropped
little hints in the movie, too, that this is his child. This is not his child.
Yeah, but somebody brought up, the baby didn't look like this movie casting. Like, you don't go by actual looks because we always went by how stuff looked in movies, then none of the movies would make sense.
Yeah.
All right. Because I could be like, he's not really a Marine because look how he's wearing his uniform.
Yeah.
Right. Like, come on. We're not going to do that. What we're going to do is what they tell us in the movie and that sort of thing. Certain things you just, when it comes to casting, you can't cast family members to play. So they just cast who they cast.
You know.
And they gave you a clue that it was this, that they looked alike by the character explaining that they look just alike.
Mm-hmm. And then, because of this conflict, Anthony is pressured, and then he's like, okay, I'm going to go out and I'm going to do this robbery, and then everything really goes downhill from there. But when you look at what started the conflict, it can be, okay, in the short term, you could say it was Cuddy, right, coming over, confronting, and all of that. But then when you go back, the whole reason this exists is because he didn't acknowledge his family and his child, and take care of them while he was gone. This is where the pressure is coming from. Juanita, you're not reliable.
Hmm.
That's what a woman is looking for in this type of situation. She got to know you're reliable because Juanita is pregnant, belly out to here, being this doggone CNA. You know what I'm saying? Like, think about that. That's a very physical labor type of job.
Hmm. Yeah.
And going to school and doing all of these other, you know what I'm saying? Like, come on. It can't just be that you're in your head. Now, I'm not going to ignore the mental health things that Anthony was suffering. But also, at some point, Anthony needs to get some help, too.
Yeah.
You know, like, but at what point is it your responsibility to start?
Well, so, you know, I would say the 70s is a different time.
It
right?
Is.
When it comes to mental health and all of that. And what we do know is he ended up on that bus at the end. And to be avoided is probably something a lot of people don't want to hear. Abstinence.
He should.
Abstinence as a kid, right?
Uh-huh.
Possibly marrying somebody who, at a young age,
mm-hmm.
Possibly putting your kid on the pay.
Mm-hmm.
Not getting Cleon involved. Yeah. Because Cleon, he snitched. The thing is, you didn't have cameras and everything back then. So if nobody says anything, nobody's really going to know. Hey, the pastor is throwing money around. Oh, God gave me this money, right? And mm-hmm. then there, you don't know that it's from a robbery.
Too many things are unpredictable, I feel like, in this. To say, like, I think you have to avoid the robbery altogether for Anthony not to be on that bus. Like,
right.
He has to have enough going, enough things. But I really think that he could have if a lot could have been resolved if he had just married Juanita. The pressures would have been there when he got back, but he would have had a home to come to. It just would have been a little bit easier, I think, on him. Less to figure out.
Yeah, but ultimately it comes down to economic system, which is the reason the Vietnam War was fought.
Mm-hmm.
Over competing ideas of what an economy should be.
Yes. So we have really, really enjoyed talking about the movie Dead Presidents. I think it is underrated. It's not discussed enough. It's older, but it is an excellent movie. Like we said, if you missed our deep dive that's like about 2 hours long, go back, watch that. It's in the comment section. Watch our other deep dives. There's one that we did on Minister Society. We did another one on higher learning. Catch up with all of that. Catch up with all of our content. Share it with your friends. All of that good stuff, because it is important to have these discussions. As you can see from this one,
right,
these discussions take us into real world, real life scenarios.
And I believe there are two other polls that we didn't fully discuss that may be going on our other channel, Station B.
Yes.
By Axiom Amnesia. So you need to subscribe to that. But if you made it this far in the video, type "need dead presidents" in a comment so that we know you're one of the real ones who made it this far into this discussion video.
Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel, and check out one of our other videos on the screen right now. If you like fan theories, movie trivia quizzes, and movie discussions, please subscribe to our other channel, Station B by Axiom Amnesia, so you won't miss out on any of our fun discussions.